okie dokie, today's the day for you. The day already happened with me and Joey, but you get to see it a little bit.
Oh, Joey.
Who's here? I'm Jacob.
I'm Aidan.
We're here to watch just the first couple hours of Kingdom Hearts 2. If you're not already aware, Aidan over here has watched our playthroughs of the games and not really played them herself. What was that? What were you saying?
It's the blonde one.
Huh? Who?
It's the blonde boy.
Oh, you mean from the ending of Chain of Memories? Hmm, interesting. Interesting stuff, isn't it? This is the final mix art, the original art in the PS2 version. You remember how the art in KH1's menu was Sora on the beach with the water lapping up to his feet? You can hear waves in the background right now. That's because the original art was him standing on the beach again, except instead of just like a piece of wheat in his mouth, mm-hmm. he had a popsicle and his new outfit.
The boy's hands are still abnormally large.
His hands are still abnormally large, yes. But anyway, so Aidan over here, if nobody doesn't know who she is, she's familiar with Kingdom Hearts and that she's watched our playthroughs and we've done some other stuff. We filmed a video where we kind of talked about KH1 and Chain of Memories for a while. We also played the Game Boy Advance version of Chain of Memories for a couple of hours. But today, we're actually going to play the... Oh, I don't want to load. What am I doing? Uh-oh. Hold on. My bad.
You're good. You can use both hands if you would like.
No. I was just like, I needed to hide anything that popped up in the load, like if there were any names in there. I forget how far me and Joey are at this point. No, I know exactly where we are, but I didn't know what files would pop up.
Right,
anyway,
right.
No, you're good. You can look now. We're just going to be opening up over here. So, yeah. We're going to be playing just the beginning of Kingdom Hearts 2 today, so you're not in the full playthrough of this, obviously me and Joey
are doing that.
But I thought it would be fun to play just the beginning of the game with you.
Okay.
Since you haven't really gotten to experience any of these, we haven't gotten any of your fresh reactions
to this
hot Kingdom Hearts goodness before. So Aidan, we actually talked a bit in the ending of the discussion video we did on KH1 and Chain of Memories. We talked a little bit about your expectations for this game.
Yes.
I can see you're shaking a little bit on
I'm already nervous, yeah.
How are you feeling right now about this?
There are options for how this could go, and I'm not entirely sure that I love any of them.
What does that even mean?
I don't know. Like I said in the other video, I try to not expect things, because when I expected things, I was a little bit let down, so...
We're talking about Chain of Memories in particular, where you felt you expected too much of it.
Yes, I did. I'm trying to not expect things.
Well, I mean, but are you... Whatever.
I'm excited, but I'm nervous.
Okie dokie. What are you nervous about, though?
I don't know.
If it's bad?
Getting my heart broken.
Okay, whatever.
Getting
her Aidan is afraid of getting her heart broken. Well, we're only going to play, again, the first couple hours of the game. And also, it's actually a bit faster on critical, if you know what you're doing. I don't claim to be a speedrunner at all.
Right.
And hopefully I'm not going to wipe. But technically speaking, while many things are put in the game that make it more difficult on critical, obviously, one of many changes is that while enemies' damage output is increased significantly to the point where, like, some of the basic enemies of the game, especially early on, can one or two shot you, your damage output is also increased. So for people who really know this game, again, not me, but just as a general example, people who really know this game, it's actually faster for them to play on critical because they can kill faster. Oh, more poetry, yay, my favorite.
I want to line the pieces up, yours and mine.
My favoritest. That's not simple and clean. That's a new Kingdom Hearts theme song. We have a new theme song for this game. Oh, no, look, she has her little charm. This is a flashback, Aidan. Okay. This is before that happened, see? Unless you made a new one. Nah, see, look, she's there with her boys. Everything's fine. Everything's cool.
She's there with both boys. That definitely... I mean, it looks really rad, though.
Mm-hmm.
No! Oh!
We just got just a nice little recap of some important events from the first game.
Okay.
Important thematic stuff, I guess, since Kairi and Riku didn't literally turn to dust in the wind.
Yeah.
It's more of just more just the idea. Joey was joking, this is just the source of 1,000 AMVs. It's just, that's all we're looking at right now.
Oh.
We probably should try and talk during this a little bit so the copyright.
Yeah.
So we can hopefully keep the music in here.
Okay. This is. I just want to take it.
And
yes.
I don't want to disturb it for you too much because you're watching this for the first time, and I want you to be able to enjoy it. But
this is. It's really now. They're gonna be there. It's okay. It's fine.
Do you remember what happened in Chain of Memories, Aidan, in the ending of Kingdom Hearts 1? You're making up stuff that never happened right now. No, this is the very, very ending, remember? Where he's getting sucked away and all the worlds spring back to life and there's all the stardust falling around her? You remember? You remember these exciting events? I love that shot so much.
Babe.
It's so beautiful.
Oh!
Hmm.
It's been that long?
How long did we leave her there?
No! No! And why is she talking to Naminé?
Because anime.
And is she still alone as well?
No, we're playing with time a little bit. That was clearly, obviously, a skip forward for Kyrie, but now we're back to the events of Chain of Memories.
Okay. That's alright, I guess. Take him out.
Cool.
Take him out.
How long has Kyrie been there, I wonder? She looked. How's that, Aidan?
Don't worry about it. His hair is more blonde in that.
Who, Marluxia?
Yeah.
A touch, yeah. The shading on Marluxia's hair changes drastically depending
across
on GBA.
Versions, yeah.
GBA portrait, GBA battle sprite, FMV, normal cutscene. Like, his hair always looks totally different.
Great. Oh. Hey! Oh, she already knew he was gonna be... This is not how that happened.
Aidan, this is artistic liberties are being taken right now.
Fine.
Artistic liberties are being taken.
What is she?
She's mouthing with the words of the song for no reason. This is just like simple and clean. The lyrics don't make any sense. Don't worry about it. Because it was originally a Japanese song that the same singer switched over to English where the meaning is totally different.
Okay.
It's actually funny because I would say that the Japanese version of this song is the best Kingdom Hearts theme song, but the English version is the worst Kingdom Hearts theme song. Like, that's the... I don't know.
Oh, there's all three!
Aidan, it's just symbolic. It's just
Blonde
nice,
Boy.
Nice, fun, symbolic imagery, Aidan. Don't you worry about it too much. Don't you get too excited. Did you not see Kyrie standing there on the beach, visibly older?
Look, I'm trying to put together pieces. I don't know...
You want to line the pieces up, yours and the game's. It took me like 10 years. Now I understand the poetry. That's what it was talking about. It was a prediction of how the viewer of this FMV would feel. Finally makes sense now. It just clicked. Nomura, secret genius, sleeper genius, figured it out. That's just like what happened with Sora at the beginning of KH1.
Yep.
He landed on the little platform, except that time it was a platform of Sora and his bros instead of Sleeping Beauty. No, Snow White. My bad, not Sleeping Beauty.
You have arrived.
Oh, yikes.
I've been to see him.
Who?
He looks a lot like you. I'm what's left.
Wait, there's no voice acting for him.
There's no voice acting for the other guy.
I'm all there.
Though you may remember
was.
That in the secret ending of KH1, we saw this scene, but with no voice acting, and this character said, I've been to see someone who looks a lot like you. The same dialogue.
Do you remember your true name?
And I told Joey at the time that this guy, the one who's speaking, is the secret boss that we fought with the lightsabers from the last game.
Sora?
Because, like, there's no secret to that. Huh? What? Aidan is shushing me from off screen.
Give me a break, Kai.
Giving up already?
What is...
If there are any other worlds out there, why did we end up on this one?
What, did you think it was real? And didn't you realize it was a flashback?
I don't know what's going...
Connected.
Who's there?
Why are you in brown now?
That was always how he looked. They just bumped the lighting up significantly on him. It was just so dark in the original version. In the original PS2 version, you could barely see Ansem there. Like, he literally just faded into the background. You could say he faded into darkness.
You understand nothing.
I don't even...
Sora...
Oh, poor not Billy Zane. Not Billy Zane, voice acting, not Ansem. What's the matter? Aidan, like, nothing has happened yet.
I'm just frustrated.
You had a cutscene and flashbacks.
I'm frustrated.
You have nothing to be upset about. Nothing has occurred yet.
I'm not pleased.
Uh-huh. I see. It all makes sense now.
He's in Traverse Town? Still? Did he wake up alone? Twilight Town. Twilight Town.
Another dream about him.
About who?
I guess about your boy, Sora.
He's not my boy, he's Kairi's boy.
Just, you know, our boy. The boy, dat boy. Your boy. Not your boy,
yeah.
Your boy.
Yeah.
That's different.
You can't... Hey, we still
yeah,
get
see?
The...
Uh-huh.
All right.
Wasting no time on that one, let's just get right into that, shall we? Waste no time. Aidan, how you feeling right now?
Frustrated.
I know, define. Elaborate.
I don't understand what's happening with Sora or Kairi or Naminé.
Nothing
for
real. Is happening. Those were all flashbacks. Nothing has happened yet.
Well,
the only,
right, but I'm
the only
to...
event that has occurred is this guy waking up.
Oh.
With his OC crew.
I don't care about this guy. Or any of these people. Don't give me new characters to care about. Tell me what happened to the ones I already care about.
The first day.
Man, doesn't that tick you off?
Yes.
Yeah, that's just wrong.
Yeah, I agree.
Cypher's gone too far this time.
Is Cypher the director of this game?
Yeah, apparently so.
I mean, it's true that stuff's been stolen around town, and we've got a score to settle with Cypher and everything. So, if he wants to think we did it, I can't really blame him. See, that's not what really bugs me.
What bugs me is that I don't
what
care about
really
you.
What really bugs me is that he's going around telling everybody we're the thieves. Now the whole town and their mothers are treating us like the Klepto Club. Have you ever been this ticked off before in your life? Because I
haven't. I'm not sure.
Nuh-uh. Never.
Okay, we get it. You're mad. They're ruining your rep.
What to do?
Steal something.
Street cred.
Well.
Alright, he does talk.
Eventually.
We could find the real thieves. That would set the record straight. Hey, that sounds fun. What about Cypher?
That's a lot better than stealing, because I like that idea better than your idea, Aidan. I think clearing our names is better than trying to improve our cred.
Oh no! They're gone! Are gone!
Excuse me?
What? All are gone?
Huh? Ooh!
Huh?
You can't save... Why not?
But you do understand what I'm saying, right? Our... are gone.
Stolen. And not just the... the word. They stole it, too. What kind of thief is that? Cypher could never have pulled that off. Yeah. All right. Time for some recon. Huh?
His heart is returning. Doubtless he'll awaken very soon.
Does that remind you of anybody, Aidan? You're making a face.
Daz?
Diz.
Diz.
Mm-hmm. Nope, that was Christopher Lee. You got it, that was the voice. Of course, you wouldn't have known that if you just came from the GBA version, but in PS2, that is certainly the voice. Roxas. What's oh? You went oh, like...
Do I know that name?
I don't know. I don't think we've heard that name before.
Okay.
They didn't say his name in Calm when we saw him in the ending.
That name just feels familiar.
It seems something about it's familiar to me. Over here. So, since we are just playing the beginning of this, I'm going to try and blast through everything that isn't cutscene as fast as possible. If anybody wants to see more of the gameplay stuff, the details of, like, you know, going to talking to everybody and playing all the mini-games and stuff that are going to happen in here in a little bit, go watch the full playthrough, which by now should be out and well finished with the opening of the game. We're going to be blasting through this whole thing very quickly. Let's get this investigation underway, says boy. Yo, Roxas. Never thought you'd do such a rotten thing. We didn't steal anything, all right? I'd like to believe you, but who else would steal that stuff? What stuff? As if you don't know. Hey, I'm not gonna tell you. Go over and ask at the accessory shop. Yeah?
What?
What a rip-roaring adventure.
What?
Go on, Roxas, ask her. So the cutscene walked us over to the person to ask, and then we left the cutscene to ask. Oh, hello, Roxas. I guess, whatever, lady. Lady, whatever. You should take lady. Whatever.
I'm not invested in this, I don't care. Oh, it's you, Roxas. Please don't let me down. You used to be one of my favorite customers.
Used to be. Not anymore, though.
I'm not a thief. Okay.
It's not fun having everyone suspecting me, you know. Despite his hair, Aidan, and his fashion sense, he is not a woman.
I know.
I can take care of Roxas.
Then you gotta find a way to clear your name. The woman at the candy shop is pretty disappointed, too. So, we're gonna walk to the candy shop.
Oh, no. More than that's gonna happen at the candy shop.
I'll take you to the candy shop.
It's about to get really exciting at the candy store.
Have you seen my cat around? Oh.
Solved! Mystery solved. Final boss completed. That is a lock-on tutorial, by the way. That's what that is. That's the tutorial on how to lock on to enemies. Is they say, here's a cat, now press a button to lock on to it. I'm mashing through all these prompts, but this is a tutorial right now that we're sitting through, Aidan. Does anybody remember the tutorial for Kingdom Hearts 1? Where you're in a mysterious magical land and you fight monsters?
Yeah.
I'm not saying that tutorial was perfect, because it's not, but just so you know, we didn't do it.
I believe you.
Whatever she says. Thanks for that, ma'am. So what did they take from you?
My precious.
Looks like the culprit is going around stealing. That's
oh, and
idea.
Not just.
I know, the comment bubble isn't quite making it clear, but yeah. She's lip-flopping over there.
And not just, but the word, too.
This isn't your average thief.
I wonder if Cypher would know anything about this.
We gotta talk to him. Come on, to the Sandlot. Sandlot?
Wow!
Sandlot? Let's get it rolling, boys and girls.
Alright. Is there a beast in the Sandlot?
Huh? Beast?
Is there a beast at the back of the Sandlot?
No, Aidan. Not quite.
Is there a Kingdom Hearts version of baseball?
I wish.
Is there a Benny?
Hey, check out this Sandlot, this vacant, undeveloped lot. That is completely surrounded on all sides by buildings and carefully curated. So it's really more just like a park that happens to have sand in the middle. That's what a sandlot is.
These guys.
So just so you know, Roxas and his crew of boys and a girl are all Kingdom Hearts original characters. These three and their boss, Cypher, is going to show up in a second, are Final Fantasy characters. On the left, you got Raijin. On the right, you've got Fujin. In the middle, you've got Vivi, and we're going to meet Cypher in a second. Fujin, Raijin, and Cypher are all from Final Fantasy VIII, which is why he has an 8 on his pants, I guess. And Vivi is from Final Fantasy IX. Vivi is out of character and does almost nothing, so you can pretty much completely disregard his existence.
Oh, yeah?
Nice comeback there, Blondie. What'd you say? You can give us back the... now.
I would if I knew what it was.
The only ones who would take it, you know?
That was undeniable proof that we totally owned you, lamers.
2005 so dialogue, ladies and gentlemen.
Burn it.
I know technically the US release was 2006, but whatever.
To prove that you're losers.
Replay. I think it's photographs.
Now you're talking.
What, the missing word?
I guess if you get on your knees and beg, maybe I'll let it slide.
Does he have a tan line on his chest, or is that supposed to be his pecs?
I don't know. Let's inspect this closer, Aidan.
collarbone.
Yeah, I think it's just shading. I think it's just shading on a limited poly model. We got to represent that muscle tone some other way.
What is going on?
What is
going on? Spoons?
Spoons? What is spoons?
It's a card game where once you have four of a kind in your hand, you have to pick up a spoon, and once one person picks up a spoon, everyone has to pick up a spoon, and the person who does not get a spoon, because it's like musical chairs, there's one less than the amount of people, the person who does not get a spoon is out, and then you start over.
So, I guess we'll just read these. If I were you, I'd go with the weapon in the middle. Cypher has to pay. Watch your opponent well. When he lets his guard down, strike back. If you do that, you'll be sure to win. The weapon on the right's not bad. You can use it in struggle, too, so it should be easy to fight with. What is struggle? There were posters for struggle in Chain of Memories, remember? So you remember in Kingdom Hearts 1 where we had to pick our weapon and that affected, like, our stat growth and stuff?
Yeah.
No such thing here. This just, whichever one of these we pick gives us a 1 point buff to one of our stats. 1 point to magic, 1 point to defense, 1 point to strength. I'm gonna take defense, because especially since we're playing on critical and we can die real fast, 1 plus to strength is actually a big deal.
You've become calmer. Plus one.
Roxas, focus!
Shut up, and I'll do it.
If you didn't yell.
Yeah, exactly. Glad we were on the same page there, Aidan. This is why we're here. It's because we're both in there together, you know?
Kneel, loser,
says Cypher. I don't care about how to play video games. I know how to play video games.
So what is this, just like a nerfed sword?
It's a nerfed sword, yes. That is absolutely what it is. It's a nerfed sword.
Great.
Come on. Quit playing around and fight.
Oh, he's gonna pass out again.
I don't think so. I think that was just a visual effect.
Oh.
Information. Defeat Cypher.
Oh, sure, wow.
I'm glad you gave me that information.
Wow. Wowie, wow, wow.
What?
Wait, do we have a Keyblade?
No. No.
That's what's by attack.
That's just the command menu. Oh yeah.
What is he doing with his arm?
I don't know. So yeah, that's how his fighting stance is in Final Fantasy VIII too. So, where he's slightly older but not much wiser.
Nice try.
So you may notice down there the command menu is actually themed for our current location.
Uh-huh.
It's not just the empty menu. That's one cool thing that Kingdom Hearts 2 does is depending on what world you're on, you can set the menu. You can set it to be like just the blank blue like it was in KH1, but it also has that little themed thing where it looks like the setting that you're currently in.
That's kind of cool.
Yeah, it's kind of neat.
Cypher's not feeling so hot, you know?
Tournament decides.
Well, that's a terrible picture. You can't even see the defeated opponent in the background. Excuse me?
All right.
What was that?
The thief?
Cool.
Cool what?
Now we know who took the pictures. And I was correct. It is pictures that they're taking.
Wow, 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 wow,
wow. What is
Wee! Woohoo!
Is that like a Heartless?
I don't know. It's got some very impressive animation warping on it, though.
Yeah.
Right? That's something I talked with Joey about. The warping on that model is really impressive.
Oh.
So the game wants you to follow. What was woo?
We're in the woods now.
The game wants
in
you
the
to.
The woods.
The game wants you to follow what's his face. You can just run past him and head to the correct area. What's up here, I wonder?
Question mark.
Mm-hmm. Until you go into a new area, it's always question mark.
The old mansion. The old mansion? Do we get to go in it this time?
I don't know.
Is that the ghost of Dude Boy?
The ghost of Vexen?
Yeah.
This is Vexen's ghost? Yeah, sure. We have come for you, my liege. Huh? What? Huh? Nani?
Rah!
Oh no, there's zippers in their actual body now.
That waist, though.
What?
Look at that dude's waist.
It's Which waist? So... My waist or the
no,
monster's waist?
No, the white boy. That doesn't help.
I was gonna say earlier, but I didn't when Hayner was talking about, like, we were making jokes about street cred, and I was looking at his camo pants, and I was like, these kids are pretty white.
That waist. The monster's waist.
Yeah, that's quite a waist right there.
Now it's Keyblade.
What is this thing?
Kill him.
Kill him. You can kill. Killing can happen.
Kill him.
So yes, obviously Nerf Bat wasn't much use against whatever this thing is.
Fight.
Fight. Win. And call me when you get back, darling. I enjoy our visits.
Ah. So I didn't get a great look at this thing's head, but it looked like they did have at least some sort of similar to the Heartless insignia.
It does have a logo on it, but it's not the Heartless logo.
I said similar. Mm. I said similar.
I was saying, you know, you're right. There is absolutely
a
logo.
Hey, all the
it.
Pictures. And now it's back to Nerf Sword, or gone.
Just gone totally. Okay, neato.
You traded.
I feel like we traded down. It's a distinctive down.
Yeah,
right?
For sure. We can't go back to Cypher and throw pictures of his face and win. We're back in. All right.
This little spot they hang out in.
Yeah.
What's this?
I was. We're gonna see later. It's basically just kind of like an alleyway under the train tracks. They've converted it into their little hangout.
Together. It's a really nice photo.
Hey. Oh.
Hey. You just said photo.
So, Roxas, tell us about the picture thief.
Not much to say. The pictures were just lying there.
Then how do we prove we're the ones who took them?
Why don't you say he was a weird white monster with hips that went all the way?
This,
you can say things. He doesn't look happy. He has a generic blank face.
Anybody else notice that all the stolen pictures are of Roxas?
Oh, so that's why everyone thought it was us.
And Cypher didn't go around accusing us after all.
Are they really all of me?
Yep.
Can you not see?
I don't think he looked at all of them necessarily. No. There were probably a bunch of stolen pictures.
Right? Every single one. Wouldn't it be weird if the thief wanted to steal the real Roxas or something?
Whoa, that's crazy.
Why would anyone want to steal a bonehead like Roxas?
What a ridiculous idea.
Hey, look, we got another main character who seems like the bottom of his friends group.
I don't know. I don't feel like either of these guys are as douchey as Riku is at the beginning of KH1.
Oh, yeah, no, for sure. He Plus probably isn't even the bottom. He's probably, like, the middle rung.
There was that moment where the girl, whose name is Olette, like, kind of threw a sideways glance at him when Hayner was super pissed off. Hayner's the dude with cargo pants.
Okay.
She kind of gave him a sideways look, like, you gonna say something?
Yeah.
It's like, you know.
I don't feel like he's the bottom. I feel like he's definitely not the top, though.
If I was gonna profile, it's either the girl or the fat kid. Just saying.
I feel like
that's
girls,
how these things work.
I feel like girl's on top, but she doesn't want to, like, abuse the power because she's worried if she abuses it too much, she'll get bumped down.
Maybe.
I feel like she and,
Who's there?
That's,
who are you?
That's Haley Joel Osment.
That is Haley Joel Osment.
I know that boy.
You know Haley Joel Osment? You haven't introduced me? I have so many things I want to ask him.
Hey.
Organization miscreants. They found us.
But why would the nobody steal photographs?
Oh,
both are nothing but data to them.
What'd you say?
The fools could never tell the difference. We are running out of time. Namine must make haste.
So we're finally getting the nobodies, huh?
Maybe.
I was warned.
You were warned? What were you warned of?
That I was gonna hate it.
I know. Did I say you would hate it?
I don't think you said anyone was gonna hate it, but you definitely were like, yay, there's a bunch of stuff that when this happens, you're gonna be like, what's going on?
No, I think, as I recall, it was that whole discussion I had midway through the Riku's playthrough, and I just said, like, that it's not gonna be, like, there's no reason for it to be a big secret. Like, it's just kind of information.
Come at you out of nowhere.
Oh, yeah, I should mention, Leon also has a new voice actor in this game, and so they redubbed this bit so it would have continuity. I'm pretty sure all the FF crew have new voice actors. I don't remember if Yuffie has a different voice actress, but Aerith does. And it's a big shame because Mandy Moore did Aerith in the first game, and it is definitively the best voice that Aerith has ever had. And the Aerith voice in this game is probably the worst that they've ever had.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade.
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
But the boy is a problem. He found one of the keyholes.
So we're just kind of, it seems like every night we're getting a little, or we start opening with one, we got one there, we're getting little flashbacks to kind of fill us in on the, remind you what happened in Kingdom Hearts 1 a little bit if you're not up to speed.
So why is he also getting Sora's memories?
He's having dreams about him. I dream about Sora. They're mostly stress dreams about editing videos, but technically speaking, Sora is in them.
A keyblade.
Oh.
I had a stress dream the other night where I almost locked myself out of my car with no phone and no wallet in a city in another state. I barely, like, I'm in the dream, I caught myself and went back.
Oh. Sorry about that.
What?
My laughter's gonna be kind of subdued because I've already laughed about all this with Joey fairly recently, but we got a good chuckle out of that one.
Hey, popsicles.
Thanks.
Point this half-eaten thing that I've got.
I think that was a fresh one for him. Riku waited like an hour to ask that question.
Wow! Foreshadowing.
Where did that come from?
Nah, he's just thinking deep thoughts.
You know, just thinking out loud.
Well, this happened in the last one too, and then the island fell apart.
Yeah.
Isn't that
what
growing up's all about?
But look, that's what growing up's all about. That's the point.
How often we see each other, but how often we think about each other.
Oh.
Right. Get that off a fortune cookie. That's it. No more ice cream for you.
This is a good takedown, Pence. I like it a lot.
Today's turning out to be a drag.
Maybe because of yesterday's memory thief.
Nuh-uh. You know what it is? We don't want summer vacation to be over. That's all. So, how about this? We all go to the beach.
I like this plan.
No, beaches are bad.
Why don't you like beaches?
Because Kairi's on a beach all alone. Entire vacation.
You haven't gone to the beach at all?
Blue skies. Let's just get on the train and go.
You're gonna cause your planet's destruction. Stupid
no?
camouflaged
Aww,
scrub.
Come on.
Why do you have camouflage Converse
forgot,
on?
We're broke.
Those stop being cool
you
in like
I'm smart.
2010.
Aidan, you gotta speak up a little bit. Your energy's very low right now.
I'm so over this.
Over what?
This is not who I care about. I don't care about these scrubs going to the beach. I want to see the people that matter.
Hurry up, Roxas.
These are not the people that matter.
I was hurrying, man. The game was tutorializing me on save points, okay? But I didn't even save. I mashed through it as fast as possible so I wouldn't lose track of you guys, all right? Cool it, Pence. I'm right behind you.
I really thought you were calling him Pants for a while.
No, no, no.
Just realized.
No, no. Pence is a shorter, wider gentleman. Hayner is camo shorts and shoes. I love that his shoes and his pants match. That completes the character design as far as I'm concerned. Like I can't say that I actually know a guy who dresses that exact way, but I do know that guy.
Yeah.
Alrighty. Twilight Town map. So, this game has significantly less complicated map layouts than the original game, but it's still, this is the one that gives you little mini-maps or whatever. Anyway, is it gonna let me go? Yeah, the usual spot. So yeah, this is just kind of like their little hangout that they go to sometimes, or I guess all the time, whatever. Oh, crud, the camera's still inverted and I can't fix it yet. I gotta complete a couple more things where they let me fix the camera. Welcome to Twilight Town. Hayner and Pence and Olette's favorite sofa. Welcome to Twilight Town. The darts you and Hayner always play with. So it's just kind of like this little spot underneath, you know, just happens to be underneath. We heard like trains rumbling mm-hmm. over them, so we assume it's like kind of under the railroad tracks or something. And,
cause that's safe.
Yeah. And they've just got, you know, their little spot hanging out down here with a bunch of junk. I kind of like it.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Once we get outside, it's got the, you know, it's just a little back alley that they mm-hmm. go hide in. But yeah, we also have a skateboard.
Nice. Oh, and you have different...
We have tricks, yes.
Wow.
My favorite one, of course, is the 360 spin, where you can essentially just, if you get enough altitude, this isn't a good spot to do it, but you can basically just do this number forever and ever. Anyway, that's enough of that. Back up this direction, shall we? That's where everybody went anyway. That was about the most screwing around I'm going to do. I wanted to show you the skateboard.
Okay.
After this, we're going to be full-on speedy
go.
All the time. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Hey.
I'm coming. Struggle. Oh, the same poster from
Just
Chain of
2 days to go. You and I have to make the finals. That way, no matter who wins, four of us split the prize. Okay, you're on.
You asked if there was a, after the Sandlot. You asked if there was a Kingdom Hearts equivalent of baseball.
I guess this is.
There is a sport that they are playing, but it's not baseball. Now let's get down to business to defeat the Huns. One ticket to the beach is 900 money. How much for four of us? 3,600 money. And 300 each to spend there. What's that for all
48?
Of us? Yeah. Mm-hmm. Total of 4,800. Okay. To spend on what? Pretzels, of course. What else is there? Oh, there's always watermelon. Too pricey. They're like 2,000 money a piece. That's very summer, especially in Japan. Watermelon, big deal there. Pretzels it is. So, where were we? We need 4,800 money altogether, but all we have is...
20.
I've got 800, 650, that adds up to, what does that mean? That's,
1450?
Yeah, 1450. 150. So, 1,500? Is that right?
600. Because we had 250.
1,600, right, okay, sure.
Do you not have anything to contribute?
Yep, he doesn't have, yep, I was, when I played this with Joey, I was like, did he just skimp out on adding any cash to the pot? But I was like, I hadn't paid attention to the numbers. So Hayner is flaking out. So he'll let turns, but doesn't say anything. So I was like, is he trying to skimp out on, you have until whatever time to earn 800 each. Meet at the station with cash in hand. You bum!
Didn't he say he had it covered?
Whatever. Those pretzels are sounding pretty good. Yeah, I was taking a Lutz dialogue, but I'll let you take her. Sorry. Whatever. Next time she has a bubble.
It's alrighty. Fine.
So there are 6 mini games you can play, and he told you get 800 money. All you have to do is complete one of them to move on. So you just gotta make 50 bucks, mm-hmm. and then you can just leave. Your friends are a little bit upset with you, but it doesn't matter. So we're just gonna do the fastest one, which is delivering mail. I'm hitting the wrong button. Jump, there you go. Crud. I'm screwing it up. My camera's still inverted. It's really messing me up. Okay, did not get it. I'm gonna get it now. Not gonna get it now. Wow.
Do you have to deliver mail to that bird?
Yes, that bird has mail. There we go, all right. Now I'm gonna change my camera. I totally forgot I needed to fix my camera. And that, honest to God, cost me like 20 seconds. Not 20 seconds, but it cost me like some time. Whatever. Yeah, there are mailboxes around, but that's not what we need to deliver mail to. We're delivering mail to birds. Anyway. Config. I believe it's, I want left and right reversed. I don't remember if I want up and down reversed as well. No, I do not want up and down reversed. Okay. There we go. All right, you see, look, there's mailboxes around,
yeah.
But we're delivering them to birds for some reason. Hayner said he'd take care of things, but I knew something like this would happen. He, work on this board, whatever. Yeah, I don't know, I'm just bothering to talk to people since I was talking all about how this is gonna be about speed! Check that out. He doesn't even need to put his foot on the ground or anything. He just coasts straight up that hill, like Sonic 06.
That would be really cool.
This game came out in the US in the same year as Sonic 06. That's weird. Whatever. How's work going? Looks like you've earned enough, when you've earned enough cash, come back here. Oh, do I need to get 50 specifically? Okay, I did, yeah. See, there, I didn't do the game fast enough. I do have to do the game fast enough to get 50. Once you get 50, then it's quitting time. I can't believe I botched that. Let's try this again with a good camera.
Hey.
There we go, much better.
That was great.
Not the optimal speedrunning route. It's better to do the lady first and then get the bird, I think, but whatever, doesn't matter. Significantly better. All right, should be good now. We're not gonna be spending any cash anyway, because we're not gonna be buying anything because we're just rushing through this so fast, so whatever.